Hey, hey, big buddy, 291 here. Just a quick video here real quick. I'll put this up sometime today after NASCAR. Big day today. NASCAR Daytona 500. Yeah, we be ready. I found this on YouTube. This, I'm not going to take credit for it. This is a... What you can do with a clothespin. Duh. You can take and make toothpick guns out of them. This is not my idea. It belongs to Grant Thompson, the King of Random. Give him a shout out here. He's pretty cool. I like a lot of his things he builds and makes. It's cool. Anyway, you make a toothpick gun. Yeah, toothpick gun. You take the clothespin apart, turn it upside down. You have to cut this out in the middle, and this for the toothpick. Do some trimming here. You can take your spring and you put it on there. Yeah, and you put it on there. Well, I haven't cut this one out. I just took this apart. Anyway, you make a toothpick gun. It's pretty cool. Go to his channel and look at it. It's pretty neat. So what I did, I thought, well, why can't you just make a bigger one? Well, I was in Walmart the other day, or in a craft aisle, and I found a big clothespin. You see this? It is, 5-6 inches long, inch and a half, inch and three quarter wide. Big old spring. Big. Let me zoom this out a little bit so you can see it better. Well, I'll zoom it in so you can look. There we go. How's that? So I made my, not mine, but his version of the toothpick gun. Darn, what's this camera? There we go. But I didn't use the toothpick. I didn't use a toothpick. I used a wooden skewer. I drilled a hole in it, put the, you know, drilled a hole down the middle. Take it apart, put it upside down, you cut this out, and then you make a 45 degree angle here for the spring. Can you see that? Right here. So that spring will sit in there. And you cut this out right there. See how this is... I'm just thinking unloaded before I shoot myself. You cut this out right here, all the way across. And I put a little groove in there for the other end of the spring. And what you do, put the spring in there, put the screw in there, a skewer in there, and you can cock it this way too. Once you pull forward, or release the spring, it shoots this skewer out. But you take the skewer and push it in there, and it'll cock it. So I don't know if you can see this. I'm going to shoot it. Where should I shoot it at? Let's try. It's pretty cool. I thought it was pretty neat. I'm going to make a couple more for my grandkids. Yeah, you could probably take... I don't know. I don't want to get in trouble. My wife is already against it already. I don't know if you can see this. I'll give it a shot. I'll give it a try. I'll shoot this bag of pit or coke guns over here. It goes pretty far. It's pretty far. What I thought about doing is taking the spring off and tighten it up more and make it more springy. So I have more power. I think that's what I'm going to do with the next one. They have a bigger one too. I have a huge clothespin. I think I'm going to get that one too. Get that one also. And make a cannon. It's a mini cannon. But anyway, that's what I did over the weekend, or yesterday. Made these clothespin guns. The little ones are cute. You can put matches in there. Put little matches. Get those matches that strike anywhere. You can put it in there and shoot them. Of course, you gotta be careful. You hit the paint or something, catch something on fire. You gotta be careful about that. But anyway, that's what I did over the weekend yesterday. I already said that. And I guess that will be it for right now. I'll get this loaded up. And maybe next week I can make some more clothespin guns. I'll make a bigger one. I'll get a cannon. That'll work cool. Okay, well, NASCAR is going to start here in about 15 minutes already. Not the race, but the pre-race. So I don't know who your NASCAR fan is, but I like Tony Stewart, old smoke. I like him, he's a good driver. And I kind of followed Patrick and a couple of other ones getting together in the range right now. Anyway, mine just went blank. Anyway, I will see you there. See me, bye.